So let's start with the memory wall, Professor. What is it?
So if you look at the performance of a processor and that of a memory, so the processor performances increase or keeps on increasing every year at a much faster rate than the performance of a memory increases. So that creates a sort of a wall that we call the memory wall, which is the gap between the processor performance and the memory performance. When I talk about the memory performance, it's a couple of things. One is the capacity that you mentioned of the total memory that you need to perform that work, as well as the rate, the bandwidth at which you can read and write from the memory. So the at the moment, what's happening with these large AI models, particularly these large language models or LLMs, is that the amount of memory that you need in order to store all the models, the activations, and all the intermediate data, as well as the rate at which you need to access all the data, are both becoming a huge yes. bottleneck in the entire workload or the computing spectrum. So that's kind of the memory wall, the difference in logic performance and the memory capacity and bandwidth that you need in order to keep on feeding the logic.
Arijit, this is your area of expertise. This week, AMD talked up their MI300X as having sort of superior high bandwidth memory. But the GH200, the Grace Hopper, is coming from Nvidia. What is your assessment of those two GPUs?
I personally think they would be very comparable. So if you look at the H100s now compared to the AMD offering that we have, of course, the HBM3 that AMD has more capacity, has more bandwidth. But at the same time, if you look at the announcement from NVIDIA, which happened a few months back, the Grace Hopper, the super chip that's going to come out, which is a CPU-GPU pair, that's kind of that'll have the same kind of HBM3 with as much memory capacity and higher bandwidth. So I think it's kind of a race between the multiple companies at the moment, which are all kind of gearing towards more bandwidth, more memory, more capacity, denser memory. So I think we are in some exciting times.
Professor, you've argued in your research that what we need is denser, more energy efficient, higher capacity memory. What's the solution? How do we find that?
So the solution can be at multiple layers of the stack. So there is a lot of work going on in new technology, which is essentially going beyond, let's say, charge to look at other kinds of material properties that can be used as memory. The next is, of course, circuits. How do you arrange those bit cells or those memory elements so that you can read, write, and access them with the lowest amount of energy, the highest performance. Then, of course, the architecture, like how do you put the whole thing together? And that also includes today more advanced packaging solutions. The idea would be to keep on bringing the memory closer and closer to the GPU or the logic as possible. So HBM3 is an example where you essentially would use something like what we call the 2.5D integration technique to bring the logic, the GPU or the CPU, close to the memory. Going beyond, people are looking at researching 3D solutions where you stack the memory on top of the logic, or even bring a little bit of the logic into the memory so that you can do what is called in-memory compute or processing in memory. So there are multiple research avenues that are being explored, both in academia and in the industry, and one or multiple of these will become the solution of the future. But I think the mantra is have more memory, denser memory, more energy-efficient memory, higher capacity, and at the same time, you need this memory to be as close to logic as possible.
Professor, we've been showing images of DDR5 from Samsung, HMB3E from Micron. You take an academic perspective, but there's work in the private sector around the world on this. What excites you most? Who is doing the cutting edge of memory?
I think different companies are doing different things, innovations are happening at all the layers of the stack. So Micron has some very interesting solutions. We have one of the large conferences in the device technology world, which is called the International Electron Device Meeting, happens in San Francisco every December. So there are some announcements that Micron is going to make on some very interesting, exciting memory technologies, which are both kind of based on 3D integration. Looking at SK Hynix, looking at Samsung, amazing solutions for flash as well as for DRAM. So at multiple layers of abstraction, from the technology, from the circuits and architecture, we see a lot of exciting things happening in the memory. And as I mentioned, it's not just the memory in isolation, but the packaging, the integration, the coupling with logic, that's kind of making the entire space more vibrant.